Hey there, I'm Megan. I'm the CEO of LUMOplay, and I wanted to give you a quick overview of the new Motion Maker tools that we will be releasing at the end of this month. The tools themselves are very similar to the templates that we have currently on our website, but they allow the creative to use better assets. So you can make some really cool things with them, and I'm just going to run you through how that works today. We are in the process of making sure that all of the templates that we currently offer are available, and they will be available directly in Playmaker from this point forward. So they won't be hosted on our website. You won't need to download previews and go through extra steps in order to test the apps and experiences that you're making. You'll be able to just go directly into LUMO Playmaker and click on Motion Maker and choose the templates from there. We have a few templates that we're rolling out slowly over the next few months. Not all of the preview assets are in, and we fully expect there's going to be some issues with this system. So I also want to make sure that you can access help and reach us if you have any questions and you need help when you're using these new tools. So having said that, I'm just going to show you very quickly the first example of a template, because this is one that I'm particularly excited about, and it's not something that we could have done with our old system. So in order to make a new app, you click on Create. If the template isn't downloaded yet, it will be downloaded. You can use your mouse or a touchscreen, or you can hook up a projector and test your experience as you build it in real time on your floor or wall. The overlay system is very similar to what we currently have on the web. You can put non-interactive graphics like logos and idle graphics that come up just when nobody's interacting on in the overlays section. So I'm just going to very quickly add an idle image here. So I'll go to my default template assets that I've been making for the new templates. And I'm just going to choose particle image, because that's the template that we're currently working on. And this glow idle image is what I want to use for the idle here. So you can't really see it too much, but you're going to see it in a little bit when I actually start changing some of the elements that are underneath it. Again, the only interactivity to the idle is that it disappears when somebody starts interacting with the experience. So it's a really good way of adding some elements that draw people in when nobody is playing with your interactive floor or wall. I'm not going to be using the mask or the logo image features just yet. Well, actually, I am. I'm going to use the logo side here, or the logo's layer here, not to add words or an overlay, but just to make sure that the rabbit in the center stays a little bit darker. And you'll see why I'm doing that in just a few moments. So now it looks a little bit sharper. These images that I'm adding now are going to be the final default template graphics. So you will have access to them. You'll be able to download them and play with them and change them all you want. So for the background, one of the things that I'm the most excited about with this system is that you can now add video loop backgrounds. We had a bunch of loops created for us by an artist that we found on VideoHive. So I'll be linking to that artist in the description if you want to reach out and get a loop made for yourself. Otherwise, these loops that I am using here will be included with the template. So this will be the default background loop for this particular template. Now we get into the really fun stuff. This is the particle system. So you're going to add an image, which is what generates these particles. And I'm just going to replace this image here because it's changed a little bit since we started building this template. So this is the particle image now, and it's a little bit smaller. I don't know if you noticed the difference. You can adjust the particle emitter size, which basically adjusts the size of the image that the particles are coming from. So if I want to make it bigger or smaller, I can do that by just sliding this. These sliders are most likely going to improve over time. So again, if you have any feedback about, you know, things that we could add to make any of these tool sets easier to use, please let us know. You can enable trails. So I'll show you the difference quickly. When you move your mouse or somebody moves over the particle system, it leaves these little electric trails on the display that are, you know, quite cool, but you may not want them all the time. So if you wanted to turn them off, you can turn them off, and it becomes a little bit more, looks a little more fluid. I personally really like them, so I'm going to leave them on. And then you have a number of choices of different types of particle shapes that you can choose from. So, you know, we've got nebulas and glows and rigid looking star shapes, and you can adjust things like the transparency So you can turn that up and down. You can adjust the rotation speed. So you can actually give, there's quite a few really interesting effects that you can achieve with this system. So if I want to turn the transparency up a little bit, you know, you can create these like very dynamic interactive experiences now with this new motion maker system. Particle size is another variable that you can play with and adjust, and you can also change the density of the particles. So if you want to add a whole bunch of them, we don't, you know, recommend adding too many particles if your system is not extremely robust. If you're working with the specs that we recommend as our minimum hardware specs, it's probably a good idea not to just like crank all these sliders, but you know, it's fun to kind of play around and see what can be achieved with this. So I'm going to go ahead and just very quickly change this to a more reasonable size and turn my transparency up so I can see my particles. And then I'm going to adjust my emitter size so it actually matches the image in the background. And as you can see, no matter what I do with this particle emitter, the rabbit in the center still stays a nice hard shape. And that's because I'm using the logo overlay to... It goes on top of everything else that I'm doing, and that gives it a really nice shape. I think I'm just going to stick to this little twinkle here. So yeah, that's pretty nice. And then I'm just going to crank my density up just a little bit, turn the transparency a little bit down, reduce the rotation speed. That's a little bit more subtle. You will find when you're working on this, especially if you've got a video running in the background, that it'll kind of jump a little bit. And even when it's on the floor or wall, you may notice a slight stutter, but it's much, much, much less noticeable on the actual end display than it is when you're building. There's a lot of stuff going on my computer right now. I'm actually capturing video as well, so it's slowing things down a little bit. And then the very last section of the particle image template is a ghost image, and the ghost image basically just puts something behind the effect so that when the particles move, you don't actually lose the image. So it's without this image, you would not really see the logo quite as clearly once the particles were moved out of the way. But here you can kind of see that the colored sort of gradient circle is still visible when the particles are moving. So yeah, that's basically it. In order to save this, you just want to give it a name. If you accidentally close this entire window without giving your experience a name, it'll still save it for you, which is kind of nice. So I'll show you what that looks like. So if I click on save and then close this, it will show up in here and it'll actually give you a nice little thumbnail so you can see the project that you were working on. And then when you're done, you just want to go through and publish it. So I'm not going to publish it yet because it needs a name, but I have actually made a version of this already so I can show you what it looks like without the preview. I guess I used slightly smaller particles in this version, but you get the idea. This is a pretty fun way to make an effect. And now that it's published, I can go ahead and push it out to other installations if you've got more than one installation. Yeah, I mean, this is just going to be a really fun tool set to play with. We have some really exciting templates coming up, and I'm going to be making tutorials for each one of our templates so that it's easy to really quickly pick up. We'll be providing some default graphics that you can download and use yourself or modify if you need to. One last quick word about this template. The particle colors come from the image. So if you want the particles to be a specific type of color, you need to provide a colored image for the particle generator. And that's basically it. You know, sorry for the low quality of the video. We're all still in lockdown, but we're really looking forward to seeing the things that people make with this system. If you have any questions, please reach out. Thank you. Yeah.